So Inglewood police have received 14 reports of potential fraud so far. People who bought tiny homes thinking it was an affordable way to achieve the American dream. None of them could afford to be swindled, and yet many fear that's exactly what happened. Trusting a felon who said he was a changed man, a man of God.
I didn't find the Lord till I was about 45 years old. I actually found him in prison in November of 2009.
This is YouTube video of Matthew Sowash from 2017 explaining how he's a changed man.
Blessed to be sent to prison here in Colorado. I was charged with 9 counts of securities fraud for the way I conducted my business.
Sowash was sentenced to 5 years after pleading guilty to securities fraud for ripping people off.
Hi, my name's Matt, and I am the production manager here at Holy Ground Real Estate, and we build tiny homes.
A year ago, his tiny home videos took off on YouTube and TikTok, presenting a changed man now devoted to helping the less fortunate buy a 400-square-foot home.
With the ministry, affordable housing is huge for us.
I really hope he's not a fraudster.
We met Samara Nate in September, a 24-year-old mom with a 3-year-old daughter.
Oh, very excited. She talks about it all the time with everyone.
What does Bella say?
We got a tiny house.
B! Bella! For Bella!
The pair had been living out of Samara's car because the tiny home she paid for in full, $64,000, never arrived in Paonia, Colorado by September 1st as promised.
It's super stressful. I mean, I feel like I have, you know, no other choice but to just trust that he's going to come through, because I don't even want to think about losing that money.
The day before our interview, Samara went to this warehouse in Inglewood where the tiny homes are built. She asked for her house or a refund. What she got was a promise on paper, her tiny home by October 14th, or her money back.
And he signed it, and so that's where we're at right now.
By October 14th, she got neither the house or a refund. Instead, she received a bankruptcy notice filed October 7th by Matthew Sowash with a stay order telling her and so many others, any contact with this business in regards to your home is a violation of this order. All customer home orders have been halted.
So far I've put down $15,478.
17-year-old Kylie Basor was hoping to live on her own when she graduated from high school.
Well, this is all the money that I have saved up. And I wanted to be living on my own at 18, just to say that, like, I did it and to be proud of myself.
Kylie stopped making payments in July when her tiny home wasn't delivered.
Kylie, do you think you're ever going to get that tiny home?
I hope so, but I don't think so.
I knew he had been a former prisoner, ex-con. But I do believe in second chances.
Teresa Meggett of Lakewood now believes she was conned out of more than $14,000. Her tiny home was supposed to arrive in July of 2021. She says she stopped making payments after Matt promised her the tiny home would arrive in September, then October, finally December.
I never got it.
What's his latest excuse?
They're not talking to me anymore.
So this house is a 20-foot Colorado floor plan.
And yet, here's Matt Sowash on YouTube a few months ago, still advertising his homes for sale.
And again, this house is available right now. It's a little over $47,000.
In fact, suggesting they're available immediately for anyone who places an order.
But it is available right now, so you can buy it, pull your truck up, off you go with your own tiny home.
So we paid $24 cash and was told it'd be done in May and didn't get it till December.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Ben Scott and Alex Mays are the only people we met who actually received their tiny home.
And by the time we got the home, like, there was, you know, there's a hole in the floor behind the refrigerator that we found, you know, scratches, the house isn't level, so drawers kind of pop out whenever we level it.
They live in Greeley, but their tiny home now sits on a relative's property 5 hours away in Springfield, Colorado, because the house is uninhabitable as far as they're concerned.
Bringing that to their attention, we were gaslit and said we didn't know what we were talking about, so we brought in a third-party contractor, and he said, hey, you know, this is unlevel. You guys need to get this corrected. Yeah, so this is it. If I take the tape off this, it just automatically opens on its own, and it's because they built this wall leaning again because they built it on unlevel ground. These blue tape, this is where everything's wrong. Like, this is a busted piece of wood that they just thought, oh, well, it's gonna be flat anyway. Let's go ahead and throw it up there.
The couple says they were told a repairman would show up, but one never did.
He said, you know, you guys are so nice, you're so patient with us and understanding. We just want you to be happy, you know, You're a lot better than some of our other customers. Our other customers are assholes.
Ben and Alex say the man who claimed to have Christian values sure didn't reflect them.
He sent out a letter to his prior and current customers saying, hey, if you're leaving bad reviews for us, you're not going to get your home. You're only hurting yourself. And then at the end of it, follows it up with God bless.
Matthew Sowash faces multiple lawsuits from customers, including from a lender who gave him $250,000 and from the lumber company who supplied his wood. Yet just 2 days ago, he posted a new video, and here's a clip.
Don't believe everything you see and hear in the media, because we're building and delivering tiny houses every day.
Sowash's attorneys tell me that because they filed Chapter 11, he can continue to operate his business rather than shut down and liquidate. This may seem odd when current customers have been told their orders have been halted, and they're going to have to hope for the best in bankruptcy court. But Sowash's attorney says he plans to reorganize and eventually repay his debts. Inglewood police tell us they continue to investigate, but so far nothing has been forwarded to the district attorney for possible criminal charges. Rob Lowe, Fox 31.
Yeah, he better.